it's hard not to have a little bit of deja vu because, of course, this was also the case with the Brexit vote. No one was really expecting the British public to vote in favor of that. Why do you think it has become so unpredictable there in the UK? Is that a function of the polling, or does that really have to do with the state of society and perhaps some polarization at the moment?
I think this election was supposed to be about Theresa May. It was supposed to be about Brexit. It was saying, I am your safe person, put everything in my hands and I will get you the best deal possible in Brussels. Obviously, that did not work out. And we know that Jeremy Corbyn surprised many people by performing so much better than was expected. And I think what he really struck on was this whole issue of austerity that has been plaguing the Conservative Party actually since 2010, with cuts to many public services, education, health, police, which obviously came out after the terror attacks. And I think that is what has really galvanised many people, particularly young voters who have come out very strongly to vote at this election. And that is what I think many of them were voting for. It was not particularly about Brexit. Yes, that's a big issue. But it was about, hey, where's my money? How am I going to definitely know I'm going to have a job? How am I going to pay for university? Why can't I get that operation now on the health service? It was those issues. And that, I think, is what has really got people angry in the UK.
So many different competing factors in this election. And now, you know, May has the challenge of forming a government. Let's talk a little bit more about that, because we know that she might end up relying, for example, on the unionist politicians in Northern Ireland for a working majority, sticking together to prevent Jeremy Corbyn and Labour from getting into the government. How stable could that option be? And would it address those issues that you were just talking about?
I think, honestly, nobody really knows how stable that is going to be. She's made the decision that she's going to go to the Queen this afternoon to try to form a government. She's then got to go back to Parliament next week when everyone reconvenes and to get a vote through to say that, you know, I'm going to do this. She's obviously still the Prime Minister. And then she's got another task of where they present their legislative agenda. It's called the Queen's Speech. And she's got to get that through. Now, she's got to compete against all those MPs who are not Tory, who are Labour and the other parties, but particularly Labour. And they have said, look, we are ready to serve. This is what Jeremy Corbyn said this morning. We are ready to serve the country. But they are also saying that they don't want to go into coalition with anyone. At the moment, they don't want to make deals, but they want to put forward an opposition. They want to put forward their own Queen's Speech and their own alternative scenarios of what could happen. So do not be surprised if there is another general election this year.
How do you think history is going to judge this moment for British politics? I mean, how have you seen it evolving over the years, and where are we right now?
It was quite straightforward, I would say, until 2010. Then we had a coalition between the Conservative Party and the Liberal Democrats. And then since then, things have changed. We obviously had a surprise Tory result, Conservative majority in 2015. But then, because of that, we had the referendum, and that threw most people. And then we've had this election, which obviously didn't need to be called. It was to try to cement Theresa May's standing and her control over the party, and that has massively backfired. And I think, you know, you cannot, as was said previously, you cannot just assume that the voters in the UK are going to do what the politicians want. They will not. They will do what they want to do, and that's just been proved.
The name of the game these days is unpredictable. Thank you very much for your analysis, Alex Forrest, a freelance journalist based here in Berlin, used to be a parliamentary correspondent in Berlin.